You're still talking about a huge number of towers just to catch up with Vietnam. You're talking about 50,000
towers.
And you're only talking about so far 23 or 27 tower providers. What timetable do we have for this?
Well, that would be very much better, no? Because for 24 years we have only two companies building towers. Yeah. Now we have 23, no? However,
but target-wise, what time frame are we looking at to have all these 70,000 towers in place?
One telco provider said that he can make 27,000 towers in 7 years. So our target is 50,000 for 7 to 10 years.
Okay.
We have two problems in accomplishing that, which Vietnam doesn't have. One is the NPA. And other threat groups that are bombing the towers.
Yes.
And another are the local government units that are slowing down the release of all the necessary permits just to start construction.
27
and to get
permits.
Right of way.
That's it.
That's what the Globe and SMART are actually saying, about, which is why they can't build more towers.
Yes.
So how are we dealing with this?
Yes, initially what we did was, as I said, offer the ICT control properties, no? And some of these have towers already, no? We have, I said, 1,500 of these. Then we can offer other departments' properties,
especially government land.
Especially, we are talking with DepEd, no? They have 40,000 public schools. All over the Philippines, we build towers in appropriate areas in these schools. That school will be provided with Wi-Fi, very fast Wi-Fi for the use of the student. We have, of course, the SUCs, no?
Sir, but won't you run into court issues there? Because I do know that there are a lot of groups that have been opposing the setting up of towers in populated areas. A good example of that is the Spariñas Village.
Oh, yes. These are private properties. Mm. Yeah, that's where the problem comes in with subdivision, who doesn't like to put in any cell site because
the fear of radiation.
Health reasons.
Yes, for health reasons, which is, of course, already... The Department of Health has already certified. In fact, all of these 17,000 that we have now are allowed. One permit there would be the permit of Department of Health. So we have put up already 17,000 towers that is approved by the Department of Health. And as we speak, there is still no concrete evidence that any of these towers have caused, anybody to have
I understand,
cancer,
sir, that if you set it up in public schools, mukhang walang problema, pero all it takes is one parent to file a case, and then things may get
that's true, that's true. In fact, that is actually similar to a subdivision not allowing. No? But we have already talked, of course, with DepEd, because they need that connectivity. In other words, we say that if you put a Wi-Fi in a certain zone, you are going to get more radiation from that Wi-Fi. Even the routers in our home, you will get more radiation from that Wi-Fi than what you will get from a tower that is maybe less than 100 meters away. No? So if you don't want any radiation, because the radiation from a Wi-Fi router is the same radiation as you will get from a cell site, no? So you must not have any routers. You must, even your television set radiates, no?
Yeah.
So that's what we are saying. In fact, in Quezon City, you have ABS-CBN and a few meter. About a kilometer away, we have
GMA.
And these are radiating the power that this the energy that these two antennas are radiating is more than the total of all the 70,000 nationwide. Mm.
Okay. Sige, patingnan natin yung story ng ABS-CBN at saka GMA.
But of course, yung channel TV5 has very less power.
Ay, sabi lang din yan.